On Thursday this week, President Museveni commissioned the Karuma 600 megawatts electricity generation plant along the River Nile in Kiriandongo. The $1.7 billion hydropower project was constructed by Sino Hydro Corporation in collaboration with the Uganda Electricity Generation Company Limited, a milestone that sharply raises Uganda's generation capacity to slightly above 2,000 megawatts. Dr. Ruth Nankabirwa Sentamu, the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, said that Karuma represents a major milestone in our national energy strategy and will significantly boost power generation capacity, enhance energy security, and support sustainable development. She added that the government has now shifted its focus on developing more electricity generation plants to meet the Third National Development Plan NDP3 target of generating 52,000 megawatts by 2040.
Icho kitegeeza nti ministry eno ekyetaagira ddala ensimbi nnyingi okuteekawo amakubo agatwala amasannyalaze eyo wansi mu byalo gye bageetaaga.
During the commission ceremony, Engineer Ziria Wako, the CEO of Electricity Regulatory Authority, ERA, informed President Museveni that Uganda now has enough electricity, with expectations that citizens will enjoy lower end-user electricity tariffs. In her speech, the Vice President Jessica Lupo acknowledged the achievement registered in the energy sector, considering the state it was in decades ago.
With this new supply, therefore, we are better positioned to attract investments, boost industrial production, and enhance the competitiveness of our economy.
Karuma's commissioning brings Uganda's installed generation capacity to 2,048 megawatts, an increase from 380 megawatts in 2005. However, President Museveni dismissed the talk that Uganda has an abundant power supply, saying efforts should be geared towards increasing the country's consumption.
If you want a modern economy, because the goods you produce must be good quality and cheap, is to have low transport costs. Number two, have cheap, reliable, affordable electricity.
Museveni explained that Karuma, as a publicly funded project, has a lower tariff as compared to the majority of the privately funded projects like Bujagali. After 11 years under construction, Uganda's flagship hydropower project, Karuma, was finally commissioned, marking an end to a long, winding journey littered with technical defects, fights between the government and the contractor, as well as other non-engineering challenges.